Yeah, I guess it's for you. Bulgaria continues to shake with very massive street protests. Hundreds of thousands in the streets yesterday only. And day by day, it becomes more and more clear that people are angry and furious with the legacy of a government which this commission has been supporting for 3.5 years. My question, therefore, is, do you feel any sense of responsibility for supporting such a government? Secondly, on September the 9th, 2009, then newly elected Prime Minister Boyko Borisov came here, and President Barroso symbolically lent him a credit of trust. Credit of trust. My question is, what happened to this credit? Does the president still trust Mr. Borisov? My third question is, the Bulgarian president, Roslan Plevneliev, is coming to Brussels on Wednesday. He'll be meeting President Barroso. That's maybe one day before he is obliged by the Constitution to appoint a caretaker government. Will the list of ministers be on the agenda of the talks? Thank you.
Okay, now where do I start? It's obviously not for the Commission, you know, to decide on which government the Bulgarian people wants to give itself. There's a democracy in Bulgaria, and we respect that. So you will not expect me in the process that is ongoing in Bulgaria to interfere in an internal political process. It is true, as I have already announced, that indeed President Plevneliev is coming to see President Barroso on Wednesday. It is also true, as we have stated previously, and I believe you've heard it as well, that we have welcomed the President's intention to uphold the constitutional process so that we can have a fully functioning government taking office as soon as possible. That is obviously very important, and that will be the best guarantee, we believe, that the concerns of the Bulgarian citizens are addressed. That is what we have said, and we, of course, stand by that statement. And for the rest, really, I think, you know, you're asking me to comment on something which is internal matters. I will not do so. Obviously, on Wednesday, there will be the meeting and an ensuing VIP corner, and there you will hear from the two presidents themselves, how they see the situation, as it will then stand by Wednesday. Okay? So I have no more to add in terms of trust vis-a-vis, you know, particular politicians or indeed other comments to make at this point in time. You still want to put a follow-up question, which of course you can do.
It's a follow-up because you are sidestepping my question. I am not asking you to interfere in the internal affairs of Bulgaria. My question was, and I will repeat it, does this commission have any sense of responsibility for continuously supporting governments which people then chase out with stones, like in Bulgaria? And this is not the case only in Bulgaria. Look what happens in Italy. In the Czech Republic, the Communist Party is second in the polls. Do you feel any sense of responsibility for backing such governments? Thank you.
I think that the first thing that I said is very clear. It's not the Commission that decides which government should be in place in Bulgaria. That is not for the Commission to decide. So frankly, I don't have other comments to make on this question. I just take the opportunity to correct myself. I said there will be a VIP corner. Apparently there is no time for a VIP corner, so there will not be a VIP corner, but we will of course debrief you accordingly after the meeting in any case. Georgi.
When my colleague said that the Commission supports and supported this government, I have several examples, but I can share with you two. One is the CVM report Romania had a CVM report and Bulgaria did not get such a report, obviously because the Commission thought that there will be elections. So that's a clear example. Another clear example is that Vice President Cruz, who was quite interested in the subject of media freedom in Bulgaria, suddenly lost interest in this topic. I can add many, many more examples. In any case, I have also a concern. A Bulgarian journalist, Radko Hanjiev, is living without electricity because he was critical to the company ČEZ and they cut his supplies. Radko Hanjiev is a very old man. He was recently diagnosed with cancer. I know that several of your colleagues, Pia, know his coordinates. And what I'm trying to do is get some attention so that Mr. Hanjiev will have electrical power back in his home. Otherwise, I think his life is in danger.
Thank you very much, Georgi. This intervention, I believe, you know, doesn't really belong in the press room. I'm not going to comment on what you are, of course, drawing to attention to a very sad individual case. We have commented on the overall situation concerning electricity on numerous occasions. I'm not aware we have anything new to say at this point in time, but otherwise, if you need to have our lines and what we've said in the past, Ryan is here in the absence of Marlene also to help you on that. On the CVM process, that is obviously not dependent on when elections take place. Mark is ready to fill you in fully on what the background is as to when and where and how we take decisions as to when we make reports. I think we have explained quite clearly what was the situation for Romania and how we are proceeding on monitoring Bulgaria, but you know, Mark is happy at any point in time to recall how we're working on that, but it's not connected with the political interpretation that you have just made, which you are of course free to make, but it's not a right interpretation. Our monitoring, our decisions as to when we make reports are not dependent on elections. They are dependent on the progress made in the countries which have such mechanisms in place. So that's really what I have to say on that aspect. On any of the details, you know, we're happy to follow up. In the margins, are there any other questions?